albeit off their lows, excuse me, concerns about further economic deterioration as a result of this credit crisis. Another interesting aspect of the market today, you guys, gold continues to get weaker. If you had looked at this marketplace and what has gone on in it and asked somebody to speculate what might happen to gold, I doubt many folks would say it'd be dropping below $800 an ounce at this hour, Trish.
Yes, good point. We're joining this conversation. We've got with us Peter Schiff, who had listened to part of Mr. Mack's interview with David Faber. Peter, you know, one of the things that John Mack told David was that we are, or at least are seeing indications that we are heading toward a deep recession. I know it's something that you've talked about at length for some time. Are you seeing any indications that we might come out of this, or, you know, do you think, like Mr. Mack does, that we could be in this for perhaps a prolonged period?
Well, unfortunately, it's going to last a long time. I think we're in a recession. I think we've been in one for some time. It's just the government numbers don't reflect it because I don't believe they're accurate. But unfortunately, the government is going to turn this recession into an inflationary depression. That is the real problem. You know, the point of the editorial that I wrote today in the Washington Post was to put the blame where the blame belongs. The government created this situation. It was through monetary mismanagement, bad monetary policy. It was through the moral hazards of Freddie and Fannie. It was through our tax code that we're in this mess. And now the government is trying to interfere with market forces that are trying to correct the mess the government made. And they're doing it in ways that are going to create much greater problems than the one they're trying to solve.
You know, Peter, I saw that article. It was a great piece. One of your solutions was that we should all just keep driving the same car for a little while longer, live in the same house, and we don't necessarily need to trade up at this rate that we have been doing. That's a slower and smaller economy, though, in the long run.
The economy has to shrink because it was phony. You know, our economy was based on spending borrowed money. It was artificial. You know, what the government wants to do is exactly what the government did in the 1930s. They want to interfere with the market. They want to prop up prices. Here, you know, the government wants to keep it so Americans can keep borrowing money to send their kids to school. Well, tuitions are overpriced. Why not cut off the credit, let tuition prices collapse so that people can afford to go to college without taking on debt? What we need is less borrowing and less spending. We need to go back to work. We need to roll up our sleeves. We need to start saving our money again and producing stuff. Yep. Because the only way to get real credit is to have real savings. The government is trying to replace legitimate savings by printing money. They're going to destroy the currency and destroy our economy.
Bill Seidman, how do you begin to get the transparency? Another, I asked a question at the top of the show. Why? You say they didn't have a secretary in the room. I'll go serve as their secretary. Believe me. I think
media,
that when we got hundreds of billions being distributed around the country to our banks from our pockets, the least we could do is get a secretary in the room so that we can see a transcript of the conversation, don't you think?
Well, it would be nice, but it isn't the way the government works. And besides, it's pretty hard to have a meeting if you know that everything is being transcribed.
You know, let me pick up on that, Dylan, yeah. Just real quick. I understand what you're saying, and I agree with it. I've been a government and the sunshine guy for as long as I've been a reporter, which is 20 years.
Yep,
I appreciate, however, the need when a government deals with a private company, the need for quiet.
Even when it's public money?
Well, no, but the result of the meeting was made public. I just think in the situation where the negotiations are happening, and look, we both basically found out what was going on in there. But in that particular situation, for example, when the Fed deals with a company, that I think needs to be remain quiet.
Yeah, I understand your point, and I think you understand mine. When we're going to the taxpayers' pocketbook to get us out of a problem that was created by the system through legislation, we'd like to get a look at how they're going to get us out.
We got to go, guys. Sorry.
Out of time.
Great discussion. Thanks to our contributor today, Bill Seidman, also Peter Schiff. That is it for The Call. I'm Melissa Francis.
And I am Trish Regan.
And I am Dylan Radigan. Power Lunch up right now.